t-shirt, have my Pipecat TV graffiti, have my script so I don't get lost, which I probably will. And Mark, you have your t-shirt.
I'm decked out as well.
You're decked out as well.
That's right. We're ready.
Let's do it. All right. Welcome, everyone. This is the first episode of Pipecat TV. I'm Aleish.
And I'm Mark.
So what is Pipecat? I guess that's the first question, and then I'll tell what Pipecat TV is. But let's start with what Pipecat is.
Well, most people already know, maybe you're building with Pipecat, but it's an open source framework in Python for building voice and multimodal AI applications. We see a lot of people building voice bots or voice agents for it, but it's not just limited to that. It can be anything multimodal. A lot of vision, interesting use cases with vision and multimodal. So all sorts of things.
Yeah, and we also have client SDKs, right?
That's right. Client SDKs, other libraries, even a new debugging library, Whisker, which we're going to talk about today.
Yeah. And we built also support for ESP32 that I have that. It's pretty cool. All right. So Pipecat TV, this is the first episode. What we're going to do, I think about it like it's going to be like the MTV for voice AI, but probably more boring. We'll see.
Yeah, no music videos, just more pipelines,
code cat. So the goal is to share what we have built with Pipecat, new features. We're going to invite people from the community so they can talk about what they are building, what they like about Pipecat, what they don't like about Pipecat, probably more important. And again, also, we're going to share the features. We're going to share like how-tos, like probably the next episode is going to be about how to get started with Pipecat, like from the very beginning, like zero lines, zero AI, the bytecoding. We'll start like maybe bytecoding. We'll see. So yeah, and hopefully the videos will be short. Now I'm taking a long time to explain this, but hopefully we'll make them short. And yeah, it hopefully will be fun for everyone. And we'll also talk not only about Pipecat, but maybe other projects out there and other companies even that build voice AI. So we'll make it interesting for everyone. So let's get started. So today we'll talk about two new releases, 0082 and 0083. Yes, we'll get to 100, but hopefully not. We will release 1.0 before that. And yeah, Mark, what did we ship?
Sure. Well, voice bots on the phone are the main use case we see most people building for, so we wanted to keep adding more features for those. So two new features were one, voicemail detection. And this is a new module in Pipecat that can detect if your bot is talking to a human in a conversation or if you fit their voicemail box. So if you're doing outbound calling, this can make it really easy to add voicemail detection into your code. And we've done a bunch of work to optimize and make the conversation response super fast, and then give you the flexibility to do what you want to with the voicemail. So that's something that if you're doing outbound calling, this should make it really easy. And one other interesting thing, IVR. So this is like a call tree. Voice bots can now navigate IVRs automatically. So we did add native DTMF tone generation into Pipecat. So if you're calling through Twilio or Telnix or Plevo or Exotel, and not tied into WebRTC, you can now generate tones. Not only that, with the IVR navigation, you can give your bot a goal. So you could say, call the pharmacy and find the billing or find the prescription information for Mark. Here's his date of birth, prescription number, etc. And it will navigate through the tree and gather that information. So that's just kind of goal-based,
right?
And all kind
so
of magic.
So what happens if it cannot reach the goal that you asked it for?
Well, we did build in for that case because it's not going to be perfect, but it would emit an event that it's stuck, and you can hook into that and log information or do whatever you want to. If it's complete, so if it actually gets to the goal, maybe you want to just hang up, maybe you want to transfer to a human, or maybe the bot talks to the pharmacist. I don't know.
Cool.
So it's really up to you, but you can hook into all of this from events.
Right. So you can also transfer to a human if you want.
Yep. Oh, definitely. Yep.
That's pretty cool. All right.
Yeah.
And for the voicemail detection, you said you just give it a it will detect if it's a if it's a voicemail, and if it's a voicemail, you can leave, like, how do you leave a message? Like a
Yeah, so there's an
pre-recorded
event that's
message,
emitted.
or how do you?
Yeah, there's an event that's emitted, so you can do really whatever you want with it. So I think it's called like on voicemail detected. And when that event is emitted, your handler can maybe just push a frame. So it would push a TTS speak frame and then hang up. Or maybe it would generate inference, or really do whatever you want it to. So it gives you a little bit of flexibility to respond how it makes sense. And we added the ability to like tune the timings because sometimes voicemail messages are long or short. This gives you the ability to just provide a value and wait a certain amount of seconds before replying so that all your message ends up inside the inbox instead of getting missed.
So for everyone who doesn't know about what TTS speak frame is, what a frame is, all that stuff,
We went right in.
we went right in, like you're an expert right now of Pipecat, but don't worry, the next video will explain what Pipecat is, what a pipeline is, what are the data traveling through the pipeline that you might have guessed. They are called frames. We'll talk about that. So maybe you can watch again this pilot episode and then, oh, like that made sense.
Well, speaking of jumping right in, why don't you show us Whisker? I mean, we'll go right into the deep
Whisker,
end
oh,
there, into debugging.
deep end. Okay, we have one more thing after Whisker, but let's do it. So again, Pipecat, sometimes you can build your own modules or processors that we call them to do specific things, and sometimes they are not working. You don't know why they are not working. Is it receiving the data, the audio? Is it sending it back, or is it receiving the transcriptions or not? So we build this debugger so you don't have to look at the logs, because when you look at the logs, it can be a little bit overwhelming and hard to follow. So we have this new debugger. It's version again 006. So we'll get to 1.0 at some point, but at least I think it's a good start for helping people how to see what's going on in pipeline. So this is a Pipecat pipeline. This one is a little bit complicated and is an example that allows you to switch from English to Spanish. And we have like two branches, which are English. I think the left one is for English and the right one is for Spanish. Here you can see all the data, the frames that we will talk about. You can see the data that is on each frame. You can even look for frames like generated, like tokens, LLM text frames, and you can see what the bot said. You couldn't hear it, but says, "Hello, I am your helpful AI assistant." You click this frame. At the bottom, you see all the processors that this frame went through. I'm just moving along this with my keyboard. On the left side, you can see how it's moved from one processor to the other. Might look a little bit complicated, but I promise it's useful. We think it's very cool, and hopefully people will be able to use that on their projects. And I'll stop.
Having spent a lot of time with trace logging, this is way improved, much improved. So I
Yes.
think if you haven't checked it out, definitely give it a try.
Yes, it is. The last thing we want to talk about is WhatsApp integration. Maybe a month ago or something, I think it was in July, June, WhatsApp announced their WebRTC APIs. So you can make inbound calls, or a user can call to a WhatsApp business. And then I believe a WhatsApp business can also call to a user in some countries, I believe. So we have initial support for user-initiated calls. So a user calling a WhatsApp business, and that's available in Pipecat since this last release, 0.0.83.
And WhatsApp, I think in the United States, you can't do outbound calling yet, but once you can, we will add that. But to get started, you can now dial into a bot using WhatsApp, which is super cool.
It is really cool. And I think we are done for the first pilot
All right.
episode. We want to keep them short. We'll have another one very soon about how to get started with Pipecat, pipelines, frames, processors, and all that stuff. And we'll have more episodes explaining more complicated features, like how we build the voicemail detection, how we build the IVR navigator, how you can make your own transports, how you can make your own processors, like, or even audio filters. Recently, we just had a new addition from a company, a German company from Germany called AI Acoustics, that they just created a filter to improve the user speech, which is really cool. It's also in this new release. So yeah, bunch of new features and hopefully new episodes very soon. Thank you so much for listening. Bye-bye.
Thanks. Bye.